everyone. This is Poonam Sagar on IndoIndians.com and in our series of Artist Spotlight, today we have with us Aarti Gidwani. Hi Aarti, how are you?
Hi Poonam, how are you?
Very good Aarti. You know, we've been following you for so many years now on the art scene and we've been seeing your wonderful exhibitions of your ceramic artworks. And now during the lockdown, you have done a new form of artworks. So before we get into your artworks, can you tell us a little bit about yourself, where you're from, where you grew up, a little bit about your childhood?
Ah, okay. You know who I am, right? I'm Indian. I have lived around most, practically, I should say, Southeast Asia.
Right.
I grew up in Delhi, studied in Delhi. Studied something which I'm definitely not following anymore. I did literature, which I thought I would write, but I don't write anymore much.
Okay.
But I then got married, went all around the world on the ships with Anil, then settled in Singapore, and that's where I picked up what I do now. And then on to Indonesia. So it's been 30 years in Southeast Asia.
Right. And you have a little, a big pottery, kiln in Jakarta. And you've been...
Yes, I have my little tiny cozy studio in Jakarta.
And you've been doing so many artworks. So, but I see that you've done a lot of paintings now. So what inspired you?
I cannot believe I did 15 paintings on my own, honestly. Even me, it's like, seriously, this is called lockdown art. I'm calling it lockdown art.
Okay.
So, for whatever reasons, just to give the background, for whatever reason, or rather I should say health reasons of my parents, I needed to stay back in Delhi. I couldn't get home. And then the lockdown happened. And then, of course, there are no flights to get home anymore.
Right.
So, here we are. So making the best of the situation, and I have a very, I will show you that painting, but this whole thing started with my Noor, who went through health issues last year. And she doodles in calligraphy. She's very good at that.
Right.
So I bought her a canvas and I bought her some calligraphy pens and a black paint and a blue paint. And I said, Beta, doodle on the canvas. I thought it'll keep her busy doing something while she's recouping.
Mm.
Well, she made a hashtag and she made an abstract form, and that canvas was lying here for 1 year. Every time I came to Delhi, I would see that empty canvas with like two things on it. And I would say, Noor, and I would tell Noor, finish it later. She would say, Mama, one day. Well, she's a lawyer, so she went back to work. No time. So I said, okay. So this time with the lockdown, I decided, and I love graffiti art. I love graffiti. I love this childlike expressionism these days, things on the trucks and all kind of stuff. So I decided to doodle. And there are artists that are really inspiring. So I've been following a lot of art in the lockdown. So I just decided to buy acrylic paints, basic brushes. And I didn't want to take away her work, so I tried to work around her work and made my first graffiti painting. And, you know, with this new India, what we call the Atmanirbhar India we've been reading about, there were a whole bunch of logos people were sending on WhatsApp that the Marlboro cigarettes will become Marlboro. And, you know, something else will, and the best was a Barbie will become Bhabhi. All kind of stuff. So all that stuff was tickling my brain.
So I decided, don't you show it to us before?
Let me show it to you. See, this is what started the painting. Can you see this? Or no, I need to turn the camera.
Yeah.
Wait. How do you turn the damn camera here? Okay. Turned it.
Yep. You can see it. Oh, wow.
So this is the first thing that I did. And can you see the prominent blue flower?
And I can see the hashtag right in the middle.
And the hashtag, that's what Node did. And if you realize there are things in it which says like Malbharo, Satsang, Adobe. And then Anil went to Singapore and he was quarantined for 14 days. His hotel room number was 920.
So it's cabin number 920.
No service. So all kind of, you know, Indian rupee. And that's why you see the signatures. I made Noor sign it. So this is what started the whole painting bit.
Right.
Very and you fun. Know, Poonam, you know me, I love colors.
Yeah, that's really vibrant.
So the colors inspire me. So I decided to just continue with colors and just play with colors.
Right. You know, I have seen a lot of your clay work, your clay art pieces, and they are so imaginative and so different. And in my last conversation with you, you mentioned that, you know, sometimes you dream of them and, you know, it starts in a dream.
Poonam, everything with me is a story. So, you know, in this lockdown, I lost two of my dogs.
Yes.
Both my dogs, rather.
Very sad about that.
So what happened was, I decided to, Noor was telling me because she loved the dog. So she says, Mama, let's do a pug painting. So I made this.
Oh, so wonderful. That's
and,
really nice.
And let me tell you, I didn't start out by making my dogs. I started out by making pugs. And then my hand just sketched my dogs. Hmm. So one is Chotu and one is Devil, and Devil's cross-eyed. You can see the cross eyes. Mm-hmm. And Chotu used to always sit with his eyes down and looking up kind of a thing. And they just happened. I mean, I didn't do them. They happened.
Right.
And while we are at it, let me tell you, this is the very first sculpture that I ever made, which is in Delhi.
Very lucky to see that.
This is the very first sculpture I ever made. This was made in Singapore.
Right.
And again, my chacha, who was my life, he said, Beta, if you want to make something for me, I want to make a mother and child.
Mm.
And those were very early days when I really did not even sculpt properly.
So
this was the first sculpture I ever did.
It's beautiful.
And then after that, Noor's graffiti painting, I did this. This is my Julu.
Okay.
This was a cartoony take on Julu, which we had kind of, you know, gotten a mug made for her, which so I took from there and I made my Julu.
So Julu is Aarti's younger daughter, Anjuli.
Yes. So we are back. Now tell me.
They are all very vibrant. In fact, when I look at your paintings, I know that it's your work. You know, it's so distinctive. So when you first shared your paintings with me, that was my first thought. And this is so Aarti.
This is so Aarti because Aarti doesn't think and just does.
So, Aarti, about your living in Indonesia, what were the challenges or opportunities that you found?
I would never say there was a challenge. Let me tell you, Singapore was a learning curve because I trained under this studio Potter who's no longer alive, Lim Hua Chun.
I see.
And he had a whole lot of Japanese ladies who used to come and learn from him. And I must say, he gave me a free hand and said, do what you want. He did not try to channelize me into doing what he thought I should learn. He told me what I wanted to learn. So I learned sculpting from him because I was never into making mugs and plates and bowls. That was never my forte.
Right.
So I decided to work there. But Singapore was, you know how expensive Singapore is. And when you're learning a new craft, you're careful. So I was limiting myself to making sure everything I made worked and didn't die. But coming to Indonesia, it was a challenge trying to find the right people to build my kiln and help me do source the clay and all kind of stuff. So a whole bunch of people came into my life. There was this lovely British gentleman called Simon Platt who was there, who supplied a whole lot of clay and everything. My glazes, you know, I get from Singapore and I get from the US every trip. Instead of shopping for clothes, I shop for glazes. So, because they have the lead-free glazes, which are non-toxic.
Yeah.
So, Indonesia, the only words I have is exploring and exploding. With Indonesia, I exploded with ideas for clay in the sense I felt free. I could just do what I wanted to do. If it didn't turn out right, I would do something else or restart. You know, I started doing clay jewelry. I started doing bags. I mean, this is all Indonesia because Indonesia gave me the freedom to build the studio at home, which was not the case in Singapore where I had to go somewhere. Plus, Indonesia has this beautiful network of a whole lot of people who will collaborate with you to do stuff. So it has been a wonderful 16 years in Jakarta where I have put clay everywhere. And as you know, Anil says, if he stands still, I'd put clay on him as well. So it's fun. It's fun. So I've had a lot of fun doing clay and a lot of boundaries where I've tried to break and do things with clay, which, you know, normally one wouldn't think where to go.
Right. Aarti, you know, in addition to the other paintings, you also showed me Hanuman paintings.
Mm-hmm.
Your Hanuman paintings.
I've done 4.
How about showing them to us?
Sure.
Let me take you. See, this is the very first I did for my daughter.
Oh, nice. And you can see that it's Hanuman.
I wanted to do a strong Hanuman because she's just recovering and I needed her to get the strength from Hanuman. Because I do believe, I have a fascination with Hanumanji and his red mouth and the whole thing. So this is the first one.
Mm.
Then I did this one, which is for my younger daughter.
And that's very playful.
And if you notice, it has honeybees all around the canvas edges.
Okay, those are honeybees. Wow.
Because I called Julu my honeybee.
I see.
So I put honeybees all around it.
That's very interesting.
And then I made this one. This is a huge one, 36 by 36.
Really,
and then I made this one, which to me represents that he's amongst us, he's everywhere amongst us.
Yes, oh wow,
it's the humanity and a hymn. So these are the 4 Hanuman paintings.
Yeah, very nice, Aarti. You kind of, you know, just taken it and made him your own.
And before I keep it down, let me tell you. For lockdown, this is my studio, my mother's dining table. These are the colors. And this is another pug painting happening for Nuri.
Okay.
So this is my lockdown studio for the time being till I'm here.
No, this is amazing, Aarti. This is so very nice. And thank you for sharing your artwork. You know, when you describe your style or your vibe, what are the 3 adjectives you would use?
Very simple. Movement, color, and simplicity.
Right.
I want what I do to give, to bring a smile to people. And I love color because, again, color in life is very important, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. Life should be full of colors.
There you are. You did the color run, Poonam.
Thanks, Aarti. It was wonderful speaking to you and looking at your paintings. Thank you so much.
Very welcome, Poonam. Anytime. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay.